There seems to be a microgenre in writing about religion and faith that is of the mind of flawed people find faith, or people explain faith in a way that makes it a little bit easier for the normal person or the broken person or the not-so-religious person to understand it. I'm Chris Brogan from chrisbrogan.com. Flirting with Faith by Joan Ball is one of these kinds of stories. It's her spiritual journey from atheism to a faith-filled life. Right out of the bat, I gotta say, I liked the book. I liked how it was written. It had that sort of hints of Annie Lamott, maybe Don Miller, only a little edgier, about the I'm not so sure what I'm supposed to be doing with my faith kind of a thing. It's a heck of a book. I really enjoyed the narrative style of it. The storytelling really worked rather well. It had very much a lot to do with her very specifically trying to, you know, hear what she felt God was telling her. And in the language of the book, she really has quite the ongoing conversation with God. And as someone whose faith is probably a lot less and a lot more diminished than Joan's right now, I guess it left me feeling that there is always a possibility for anybody, and that I don't yet have that same kind of relationship. But I'll say that the book is really good. It's a kind of book that, you know, if somebody you know is maybe sort of edging around the edges of religion or isn't exactly the stellar, ideal, immediate church-minded person, this might be your kind of book to get them to feel comfy or warm them up and have them say, hey, there's more than one way to look at this all. I found it quite an interesting book, quite a great read. It's Flirting with Faith by Joan Ball, and it's definitely worth taking a look-see. I'm Chris Brogan from chrisbrogan.com.